I mean, share my screen.
Yeah.
So, do you know what is webhook? What is the concept of a webhook? Any idea?
I have this idea to send a notification to a notification alert to particular service URL, some URL.
Yeah, actually, the webhook is a communication between one service to another service. That's it, okay? That is a basic thing.
Okay.
For example, let's say you have a GitHub. We are taking an example as a GitHub, our GitHub. Okay, GitHub is our external system, right? GitHub is an external system. We can create a lot of repositories or we can commit our files. Huh?
Yes.
So whenever commit a files to the GitHub, GitHub should send a notification to in our application. Hey, some commits happened from your side. Something like that. I want to receive some notification.
Yes.
Yeah, I want to do this kind of activity. In such a case, we can use webhook concept. This is a webhook concept. Okay.
Yes.
Here we are going to use GitHub as an example. Since we are using a local machine, our local machine is not a server, right? Not a real server. Okay. We need to act. Yes. We need to make our local machine as a real application. It's a kind of a simulation. We need to simulate our local server as a real server. Okay, for that, we need to download tool, ngRock. Download ngRock. Okay.
Okay.
Download ngRock. This is a site where you can download that tool. Okay, download, go to download for Windows. It's just a small exe file. I already downloaded it in my local machine. Okay, this is a download location where you can see one exe file, ngRock.exe. Okay,
yeah, I'll come back. Could you share me the screen, please? I'm not able to see the screen.
Oh, see, go to this file, the website, ngRock.com. There you can see download for Windows. Click the download for Windows. You will get one small exe file. Okay.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. I have already downloaded here. Okay. So it's a small exe file.
Yes.
I'll come back to later. Okay. Mm-hmm. We download and keep it. Now we're going to focus on our requirement now. See, this is a very simple web application, right? I created through my Spring initializer itself. Webhook application, I added only one dependency, okay, web dependency. I implemented one post request. It's a print. Okay, it's a print I am saying. It's a request body, it's a string. Request body is a string. API is a API/webhook. Okay, I want to expose this URL to my GitHub repository. Okay, I want to add this URL to my GitHub repository. Whenever I will commit some files, whenever I commit some files, I want to receive the event. I want to receive the event from GitHub. That GitHub receive the event from the GitHub. That event information I will get it here.
Okay.
This is the concept. Okay. Commit some files in a GitHub. GitHub send a notification through this endpoint.
Okay.
Okay. So I'm going to my GitHub URL. GitHub. Where is GitHub? Yeah, this is my GitHub, okay?
Yes.
I want to play with this config files repository. Config files repository. See here, this is my config files repository. Go to settings.
Yes.
Click webhook.
Okay.
Click webhook. Then I'll go delete this. Already I added webhook, I'm deleting that. Okay. Go to webhook and then you will get this page and then click add webhook. When I click add webhook, it asks the payload URL, which URL you want to add here. Okay. Our URL is here. Okay. What is that our URL here? This running under 80 port, that meaning http://localhost/8080/api/web/webhook. Okay, this is the URL I need to add, but this is a local URL, right? I cannot add. I cannot add. I want to make this URL as a public. For that purpose
okay.
only, I ask you to download ngRoc.
Okay.
ngRoc. Okay. What you have to do now? You need to start this ngRoc app in your command prompt.
Yes.
So go to this location, to the command prompt. Okay. Just type ngRoc. Okay.
Okay.
Then our protocol is a HTTP. HTTP. Okay. Then what is the port number? Port number is 8080. So we have to say ngRoc HTTP. Then what is the port number used by your application? Then click it. It will create one URL. Okay.
Okay.
This day, one URL is creating public URL. Just copy that. Just copy that.
Okay.
Go to your GitHub settings page and click webhook. There is it asking payload URL. Just paste it. Then this is your localhost. Actually, this URL is nothing but localhost 8080. Because whenever call this URL, it will redirect to this localhost.
Yes.
Okay. So here you have to type exact your endpoint path. So this is nothing but localhost 8080 API webhook. Whenever you call this URL, it automatically redirects to this port, this particular URI. From this URI, it will call this particular endpoint.
Okay.
Okay. Now I'll go to add this. Added now. Okay.
Okay.
Now I'll going to do one simple commit.
Yes.
Already I have opened one file. This is webhook demo. Save it. I'll going to commit this file. Git add git commit hyphen m webhook demo. Git push. Once pushed, you will receive one event here in the console. See, I got the event.
Okay.
I'll going to recommit again for clear demo. Demo one, I am saying demo one. I'll going to recommit it. Okay. Let me open two windows in the parallel, or I will going to make this small. I'm going to say git add git commit. Okay, then git push. You will receive a notification here now. Once committed, see, I got the notification. Okay,
yeah,
just to copy this. This is a notification which is coming from GitHub. It's saying that someone is committed some files. Something like that it's saying. Now in the GitHub, go to web. This is my URL where I added, right? GitHub. Go to click edit. Click recent deliveries. Whatever activity happened in my application, those histories come here actually. Okay.
Okay.
I'm going to click this. So all the detail is coming here. Now.
Okay.
I'll show one more thing here. Here, by committed. See, this is a recent commit, right? 1 minute ago.
Yes.
Yes. Recent commit. I want to see this address. Yeah. This is the recent commit. This is the ID, that commit ID. Okay,
Okay.
when you go to here, when I find this, the committed is coming here. This information you will be receiving here also.
Okay, the URL information will get here.
Yeah, yeah, that entire history, whatever, this entire data will come here in our application. Based on your project use cases, you can manipulate this data. You can manipulate this data. This is just an example I am saying. Okay, this is the concept of the book wherever you go. Okay, even your project requirement, there will be some external system. In that external system, you need to point your application URL, one rest endpoint. It's a post endpoint. Just to point it in your external system. Whenever some activity happen in the external system, that external system called that particular URL. URL, that rest endpoint. Once called that corresponding rest endpoint response will be triggered to in your application. Okay, this is the way of implementing a web book. Okay. Still not subscribe this channel, please subscribe it. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video.